Hello everyone. In this video, we will understand about welding positions based on ISO and AWS. So first, for any welding project, there is a qualified welding process or pre-qualified welding process which is decided, and after that, based on that process, welder's qualification is very important. Welder's qualification is done by engineer, supervisor, contractor, or inspector, and once welder is certified under that process, he is called a certified welder under positions like 3G, 4F, PG, 6G, and we will learn about the certification under different positions, what he needs to do to get certified under that position. Before understanding about the welding position, role and importance of code like AWS, ASME, ISO is very important to understand. Welder is certified under specific code, and once he is certified, he is always certified. Unless welding inspector is having any question based on his work or his ability. So, once the welder gets certification, he get that certification under specific range, and that is called as the qualification range. So that qualification range has some essential variables like thickness, filler metal, base metal, or non-essential variables like current, cleaning technique, and based on that he can perform his work. Let's talk about welding positions. First, AWS. You have seen certifications like 4F, 3G, 1F. Here, capital F means fillet weld. Capital G means groove weld. So there is a separate certification for fillet weld and groove weld. Also, numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, they are the orientation of the welding process. Now, one very impressive thing about AWS is welding positions and certification of the welders are separated by pipe certification and plate certification, and they are separate, and also they are having separate requirements. For ISO, positions are like PA, PB, PC. So here P means position, and they are categorized in the alphabetical order A to J, and also in ISO the positions are combined groove weld and fillet weld. So there is no separate positions for groove weld and fillet weld, but they are combined. Let's start with the welding positions based on American Welding Society, AWS. Like we were discussing that they have separated plates and tubes. Under plate category, they covered beams, angles, C channels, and plates. And under tube category, they have covered pipes, square tubes, and also rectangle tubes. And we will start with the plates first. We will start understanding about plate qualification, and based on the plate qualification we will see different positions. And here you can see the diagram of the fillet weld of the plate, and based on this diagram we will understand the different positions possible to weld that joint. So first of all, 1F. So 1F is your flat welding position, and as you can see the diagram here, it's a flat fillet weld. 2F, that is your horizontal welding position, and this is how you can see the horizontal position of the plate. 3F, that is your vertical welding position, and this is how you can see the orientation of the plate based on the vertical welding position. And finally, 4F, that is your overhead welding position. And here you can see the orientation of the plate based on the overhead welding position. So for plates, fillet weld for American Welding Society, it's always 1F, 2F, 3F or 4F. There is nothing called as 5F, 6F for plates. Now, for plates, for groove weld, that is your butt joint, based on American Welding Society. Let's discuss those positions. And here you can see the diagram of the plate groove weld. So first of all, it is 1G, and that is your flat welding position. And here you can see the diagram of your flat welding position plates. 2G, that is your horizontal welding position. And here you can see the diagram of the 2G plate. 3G, that is your vertical welding position. And here you can see the diagram of vertical welding position groove joint. Finally, your 4G, that is your overhead welding position. And this is how you can see the orientation of the plate based on the overhead welding position. So for plates, for groove weld, there are only 4 positions, which are 1G, 2G, 3G and 4G. So indirectly for plates also, there is nothing called 5G, 6G. So it's only 1G to 4G. Now let's talk about pipes and tubes for the groove weld based on American Welding Society. And here you can see the diagram of the pipe welding. So we will discuss about the different position based on that. So first of all, 1GR. Now R means rotation, and that is called as a flat rotating positions of the pipe. So you can keep rotating the pipe and perform your welding. 2G, that is your horizontal welding position. So if you are not able to rotate your pipe and your pipe is vertical and you have to perform the horizontal weld, this is how you can do. Then 5G, that is your multiple welding position, and it is fixed. So as you can see, this pipe is fixed and you have to do the multiple steps to weld this pipe. So that is why it's 5G and it's multiple welding position. 6G, that is also your welding position in a multiple direction, but your tube or your pipe is inclined 45 degree. After that, 6GR, that is your multiple welding position with restriction ring. So here R means restriction ring, it is not rotation symbol. And as you can see, this ring which is behind your weld, so you can only do the welding from one side, and that is why it is called as a 6GR. So as you can see here, the positions are 1G, 2G, 5G or 6G category. Now let's talk about pipes and tubes, fillet weld, based on American Welding Society. And here you can see the diagram between tube and plate, how they are welded. So first of all, 1F. So 1F means your flat welding positions, and that is your fillet joint, and it's rotating. 2F, that is your horizontal welding position, and you can see the diagram of the horizontal welding position. 2FR, that is again your horizontal welding position, but this time your tube or pipe is rotating. 4F, that is your overhead welding position, and this is how you can see the diagram of your overhead welding position. 5F, that is your multiple welding position, and here you can see the diagram of your multiple welding position, and of course your pipe or tube is fixed. So for pipe and tube fillet weld based on AWS, it is 1F, 2F, 2FR, 4F and 5F. There is nothing like 3F or 6F here. So we discussed about American Welding Society, and now let's talk about ISO, and we will discuss the welding positions based on ISO standards. So first of all, PA, that is your flat welding position, and it's for groove weld and also for the fillet weld. And here you can see the diagram between groove weld plate and also fillet weld flat position. So it is similar to 1G and 1F of AWS. After that, PB. PB is your horizontal welding position, that is for fillet weld only. And here you can see representation of PB. So your PB is similar to 2F of AWS. Then PC, that is your horizontal welding position, but for groove weld only. And here you can see the diagram for the PC position, and that is your similar to 2G based on AWS. After that, PD, that is your overhead fillet weld, and this is how you can see plate position based on PD. This is similar to your 4F according to AWS. PE, that is your overhead welding position for the groove weld, and this is how you can see the plate orientation, and that is similar to 4G according to AWS. After that, PF, that is vertical up groove weld or fillet weld, and this is how you can see the plate orientation and the welding direction, that is bottom to up, that is similar to your 3G. PG, that is vertical down for groove weld or fillet weld. AWS don't allow vertical down, so it is only for ISO. So it's top to bottom welding direction. PH, that is your vertical up multiple position, and that is for stationary pipes only. So as you can see, axis of the pipe and the weld of the pipe, and the welding orientation is vertical up. That is similar to your 5G as per AWS. PJ, that is your vertical down multiple welding position for the pipeline. And here you can see the axis of pipeline, and the weld direction is vertical down. There are two special positions, HL 45 degree groove weld uphill, and here you can see 45 degree axis of the pipe and welding, and its uphill direction, that is similar to your 6G. JLO 045, that is your 45 degree groove weld but downhill direction. So here you can see the axis of the pipe, but welding direction is downhill, and obviously your pipe is fixed. So thank you so much. If you have any questions, please let me know. And please subscribe to my channel.